Hello, my name's Craig Erlam, market analyst at Alpari UK, and welcome to our daily market update. Today we've got a lot more focus on corporate earnings. We've got some major banks due to report before the opening bell in the US, and also we've got eBay to report after the closing bell later on today. Focusing on the major banks, we've got two in particular in Goldman Sachs and JP Morgan. Now, both of these are expected to report earnings much better than we saw last year, with Goldman Sachs in particular due to report earnings of almost double what we saw last year, and also revenues are expected high by around 32%. Now, the danger we have with these stocks is both of these do tend to report higher earnings than analysts forecast, and the danger that we have here is that we tend to have a lot of buying in the lead up to these reportings, so that once we actually do get the reportings, once we do see these improved, these better than expected results, what we actually see is we see traders taking profits, which actually drive share prices lower as opposed to higher, which is what we usually expect when companies do report improved earnings. So this can weigh mainly on the banking stocks, but also therefore on stock indices as well. Also this morning we have a German Bund auction. Now if we look at the previous auction, we saw very low yields, so yields of 1.4%, and we also saw a bid to cover of 1.5. Now that was back in November, and since then we've seen yields start to creep higher on German Bunds, reaching 5.7%, which is where they're trading today. We've also seen Germany, which was reported yesterday, that Germany actually contracted in the fourth quarter of last year. We saw a contraction figure of 0.5%, and we're expecting that they may actually fall into recession at the start of this year, so the economy isn't quite as strong as it was perceived back then. On top of this, there's also a risk that Germany could be downgraded in the first quarter of this year. So this is going to again weigh on these yields that we are seeing on German bonds, and also the fact that we can get better returns elsewhere. If you look at the Spanish and Italian bonds, they're not quite seen as risky as they were perceived, say, 6 months ago. So we have seen these yields drop, but they still offer much better returns than we do tend to get on these German bonds. And as a result, what we're expecting to see today is, firstly, we're expecting to see higher yields compared to the auction we saw back in November, probably close at 1.5-1.6%. If we don't see significantly higher yields, then what we could see is less interest in the auction. So we could either see higher yields, more like 1.5-1.6%, or probably a lower bid to cover rate, maybe closer to around 1-1.2. Looking ahead to this afternoon, we've got the US inflation figure out. Now, this is going to be watched very closely, given the fact that the Fed's quantitative easing program is going to be pegged to two things. It's pegged to inflation and also unemployment. Now, we're expecting the quantitative easing program to start to be wrapped up around mid-2015, with unemployment expected to fall to around 6.5% there. However, it could be wrapped up early if we do start to get further inflation concerns. So this CPI figure today is going to be watched extremely closely. The figure we're expecting a figure of around 1.8% year on year. The inflation, the month on month figure, is expected to come in around that 0% area, with the core inflation figure expected to be slightly higher at 0.2%. Today, if we do see it miss these expectations, either if we see it miss on the upside, if it's only a slight miss, I don't think we'll see too much of a reaction in the markets. If we see it much higher, then this could cause a few concerns, especially given the fact that a number of Fed members have raised concerns about the inflationary impacts of this, the size of this QE program. If we see it miss on the downside, again, we could see actually further dollar weakness, as it would suggest that we may see this QE program at least go beyond the end of the year, potentially even reaching up to that original 2015 date. Looking at yesterday briefly, we heard from Jean-Claude Juncker, and he raised concerns late last night about the strength of the euro. It's currently trading around that 1.33 area, as we'll see when we look at the charts in a second. But there is still room for the upside. The one thing we can see at the moment is the fact that there's not too much going on in the Eurozone, there's not too much news out of the Eurozone. This has been benefiting the euro. We have seen it appreciating significantly over the last month or so. So we do expect it to see it, like sales. Look more at this in a second. We're expecting to see further euro strength over the next month or so. And what Juncker has raised fears is that the stronger euro can actually damage the eurozone economy. And when the economy is already in recession, expected to remain in recession for most of the year, it is raising concerns that it could damage growth even further. What this could mean now, though, is it could mean we could see at the ECB meeting next month, we could potentially see a rate cut. Because if we don't actually see further stories come out that could again, what we used to see, and especially over the last year or so, is when we do have stories come out that are damaging to the euro, raising concerns about Spain or Italy or even potentially France this year, we do tend to see the euro start to depreciate. We start to see it fall, as we saw in the middle of last year when it fell around to those 121 levels. If we don't see that, we could see the ECB take action. I mean, we haven't seen a rate cut in quite a while from the ECB, but now things are pretty different. We've got Germany contracted in the fourth quarter, like I say, expected to potentially fall into recession in the first quarter of this year, and that's the Eurozone's strongest economy. So it may ease a bit of pressure off from the Bundesbank on the ECB to keep rates as they are. So again, encouraging the ECB to embark on this rate cut. There's also the fact that we've got this inflation figure, which was released this morning, remained at 2.2%, so there's no real inflationary threat there either. So like I say, I think the ECB interest rate decisions can be watched a lot more closely next month, especially if we continue to see this euro appreciate. Like I mentioned previously, we're going to take a look at the euro dollar chart now. We've got the weekly chart up here. It has been finding resistance from that 100-week moving average. We have seen a slight pullback over the last couple of days. However, in the longer term, I do expect it to see it break through this 100-day moving average, potentially testing around 135, where you'll see resistance from the 200-day moving average and also that 50 fib level. I think a break above here is going to be quite difficult. I think this could actually be the point where we do see a reversal. However, for now, like I say, I think we are starting to see a pullback. We are seeing it trading around that 133 area. And if we take a look at the 4-hour chart, the pullback may already be over. You can see on this chart here that we have got what looks like a bullish engulfing pattern. That's where the latest candle is larger than the previous bearish candle. It has also found support from that 38.2% Fibonacci retracement level around 132.65. The key test now is going to be whether we break above that previous high around 134. If we do see it break above that 134 level, I'd fully expect to see it push on towards 135, where, like I said, I think we'll find further resistance from the 200-day moving average and that previous 50 Fibonacci level. For more news and analysis, check out the Alpari newsroom, which can be found at www.alpari.co.uk/newsroom, and you can also follow us on Twitter. My username is Craig_AlpariUK, and you can also follow the Alpari Twitter feed, which is AlpariUKForex. Thank you very much for listening. My name is Craig Erlam, market analyst at Alpari UK.